Kanthari is a plant that grows wild in every backyard in Kerala. It's a very small but very powerful chili. It is not only spicy, it has a lot of medicinal values. It's a painkiller, it lowers the blood pressure, it lowers cholesterol, it makes you awake, it makes you alert. It's a taste maker and a change creator. For us, a Kanthari is a perfect symbol for a new paradigm of leadership. I would like to take you on a journey of dreams, a journey of transformation, a journey of opportunities.
When I was 15 years old, I fell off the stage, but this became a turning point of my life. Ladies and gentlemen, let me take you on a journey today. Good afternoon, I am Srishti Kesi from Nepal.
4 years back when I met Sabria, in fact, I was seeing a blind woman who could really see, and I thought that she is only one person like her and no one is there other than her. She is special. But she showed me a lot many more people who are blind but who could really see.
Sound must say, ah, lunjuk, look,
ah, out, look, out, out,
out. My dream project is to start home called Manav Parivar. This means human family in English, for disabled old people and orphan children together.
When I think of my own life, I remember I got spiced by the first Kanthari flavor when I was about 10 years old. It was the time when I became blind, and I realized actually that I would become fully blind, and I must say I was horrified.
I was born as a sighted child. Till 13 years old, I could see very well, but I had a kind of allergy in my eyes, and I went to hospital. Doctor gave me wrong medication. Then I got glaucoma. And slowly, I started to lose my eyesight.
What I love most about being blind is that you're constantly depending on imagination, and you create an ability for imagining everything surrounding you. And I meet a lot of people, blind people, who are actually great visionaries, because a vision is nothing but imagining the non-obvious.
We are Kantaris. We grow wild in every backyard. We bring forth small but strong chilies. We are taste makers and change makers.
My name is Batihun Mary. I come from Meghalaya, northeastern part of India. I joined Kanthari because I have a dream to change or to touch the family issues, which usually is a very respective way of life in our culture. It's very much hidden. I want these family issues to come out because a lot of things happen to an individual start from the family.
I was 8 years old. I remember one morning, my dad came home fully drunk. That too, early morning. He came home. He was angry, frustrated, and said, "Give me money." He screamed to my mom, "Give me more money. I need money to drink some more." She said, "No, I don't have." He insisted. He said, "You should give me now."
We believe in is that people who have been affected by the problems, by war, by disability, and have overcome these effects, they have also the strength to do something against it, because it's their own battle. It's their own battle to fight. They're fighting not only for the rights of the margins, but they're fighting for their own rights as well. Also, there is a difference between being an insider and an outsider.
They don't have their own views on things.
They and all these kind of things. And this is something that we want to prove wrong. When we first started to think about this center and that we wanted to empower change agents, or that we wanted to create the springboard where change agents can just jump into society and change things, of course we thought of a curriculum. We asked some really good and very, very inspiring professors from universities to come together, to sit together, and we explained them our philosophy and asked them to create a curriculum. And some of them did quite well, and some of them, yeah, they also tried their very best, but it was very theoretical, and it was not at all linked to what we had thought.
And one of them was marriage.
Okay, can we stop here?
Yeah.
Little one.
Yes.
Can you jump up and down a couple of times and scream?
We always push them into situations and they have to find the tools and the methods. They have to find their own tools and methods to get out of this mess.
There is a lot of people, a lot of NGOs who work for women's issues. But what's the use to guide the women when the men don't even understand what is life? What are they doing in life? The men don't know. It's just, we just don't need to have in our mind, you are man, you know everything, but that's not right. All of us are human. We need equal respect.
Hello, banana leaf.
We need to prepare with our boat. Can you come here?
It's a crazy, creative.
You can have two people on one.
Can you come here? Right somewhere, right?
Drive on our own.
Yeah. Because I'm driving and you're pushing. What happened?
Distressing news now from the northeast. More than 800 rapes have been reported in the past 10 years in Meghalaya alone.
We called upon the people, but nobody came out.
The matrilineal society hardly any protection for women.
In our society, we have a matrilineal way of where women have equal power as men. But now when men get access to the other worlds, other parts of the society,
they get really angry.
Yes, they realize that who are we, you know? So then there's a conflict. And these conflicts and misunderstandings lead them to frustration, depression, and drink.
Have you noticed that this is always the reason given for male violence? Mm-hmm. But women get as frustrated and as depressed, but we don't beat them up. Do we? Have you heard of it?
I like that.
Because everybody is telling you, don't risk anything because you are losing something. Yeah, and somebody who doesn't have the safety, like the safety net, they can really risk something. They can go out there and they say, hey, I try at least. You know, what is there to lose? Things can only become better.
So since my birth till now, and my friends, since they don't get this education, they fall in getting married at a very early age because they don't know what is life, what is family.
তোমার এখন বয়স কত? কত বছর বয়স? 20 years. 20 years. 20 years. 20 years. 20 years.
Mm.
It's just like you come in the teenage and you are so looking for love, looking for cares. You don't get it at home. So what happened, they just meet somebody outside and then they just run away, and then a woman get pregnant and to have the birth controller. So they said it's not a good use, because if you are enjoying physically, it's a punishment for you to have a child. So all this circle of problems which makes our society really left back, which make our people grow in the same situation. From one generation to the other, you could see children are growing up and their children are begging.
This old man looks blankly at the camera after he lost his hard-earned house in a war that broke out between Nepal Army and the Maoists.
But while I was walking in the street of Kathmandu, I met a lot of disabled people. And they were begging in the street. Their condition was very miserable. And when I went and talked with some of them, most of them, they didn't have family. They didn't have children to look after them. This created a kind of fear in me.
Victims of violence of Maoism. A 10-year Nepal civil war which claimed 13,000 lives.
In Nepal, you can find a lot of disabled old people who don't have family and who are in the street, and they are begging to survive. I plan to create a new family, a family of love, a family of compassion, cooperation and bonding. So I thought to bring orphan children together, because these orphan children, most of them are also living in the same situation, where these disabled old people and orphan children can live and work together, where these disabled old people will also get children and these children will also get parents.
In the organization where I'm going to start, we're going to take the session like a training program for the youth, and we are going to also counsel the parents. And we are going to introduce children to new, you know, way of thoughts. And the children from the single parents, most of the parents becoming single, they will not be stopping their education to support the mother. But we will find ways to link them with the free school, or even to find out people who could sponsor for them. And also we are going to work very closely with the single parents and newly married people, give them counseling, give them understanding. The whole thing is to make the society understand that family is important. Breaking up is fine. Nobody will always feel like, you know, I'm husband and wife, forever we stay. But if you are not happy about it, separate. But at the same time, make sure that your children understand what it's like and how to go ahead in life.
We thought of this whole thing as a dream factory, a place where social visionaries from all over the world come together exchange their dreams of social change, but social change through mindset change. Social change through transforming concepts. Social change through spice. And that's why we found the symbol of the Kanthari totally perfect for these new leaders, new and old leaders, I have to say, you know, for the Gandhis of the future.
Told us in the past that you cannot do this project, you are blind, you know, what do you know, why do you have such big dreams, why don't you stay in Germany, why don't you have a life like everybody else?
And this
sometimes made me really angry, and I thought, don't I have a right for adventure, don't I have a right to try something, to risk something and fail and jump up again and fail again maybe, and maybe also, don't I have a right for success?
This is
the pinching point that I grew up with. I really wanted to fight for my right to dream big.
And you know what? I don't want these participants to be good boys and good girls. I want them to be spicy. I want them to go out there and create a major difference. And I want them to challenge the status quo, and I want them to risk something, to be able to fail and to stand up again. And we will be there for you, for you.
And these people, they will go along, and they tried to insist, and they say, well, stop dreaming, stay on the ground, don't grab for the stars, you are too small for making such a significant change. And then I want you to stand strong and reply, just bite into a Kanthari, and you know a small chili can make a huge difference.